Hello, welcome back to Learn Physics. In today's topic, we are going to discuss about the image formation by a convex mirror. Okay, so in last video, we learned about the image formation in a concave mirror we learned, isn't it? So, what are the rules for finding out the image in the convex mirror? Okay, so in the case of concave mirror, which and all rules we used, same rules we can use it over here also. But always remember, it is a diverging mirror. Remembering, right? In our principal focus. Okay, principal focus we learned, we told about diverging mirror. So this is a diverging mirror. Okay, so how the image will be forming, where the reflected ray will be meeting, all those things we are going to find out now. Okay, so here, image formation by a convex mirror. This is a convex mirror. Convex mirror means it will be bulged outwards, isn't it? So this is the principal axis. Here, where we will be marking our pole, pole is over here, and then the center of curvature and everything will be coming here, isn't it? Okay, and then principal focus will be here. Okay, here also we can, R equals to F, that formula will be obeying. Okay, so while you are drawing, please keep that in mind. This should be same. Okay, PF and FC distance should be same. Why? Because R equals to F. Okay, so if first rule, in concave mirror, what was the first rule? The rays which are passing parallel to the principal axis after reflection will converge through the principal focus. Okay, so but here it won't converge. So if the ray is passing parallel to the principal axis, what will happen? It will be, by obeying the laws of reflection, it will diverge, it will reflect and go. So, if this reflected ray, if I am observing, I can see that, see, it will go like this. So, this will be the reflected ray. Okay, so if I am extending that reflected ray, I can find that that ray is a straight line path from the principal focus. So it is actually not coming from the principal focus. So the ray which is diverging and going, that ray, if I am extending to the other side, I will get it like it is coming towards the principal focus. So how we will explain this one? The ray which is passing parallel to the principal axis after reflection will diverge to pass from the principal focus. It will appear to diverge from the principal focus. So we will, it is appearing only, it is not diverging from the, it's not converging towards the principal focus or diverging from the, it is appear to diverge from the principal focus. So clear now this is? Now, next, second one. So what was the second rule which we told? P, F and C. Okay, so the rays which are pass up, which appear to pass through the principal focus. So if I am drawing a ray which is appearing to pass from, so that means appearing to pass from the means, if we are extending that ray, it will be meeting at the principal focus. That's all. Okay, now extension, which other than ray, that is other than the incident ray or reflected ray, if anything you are drawing by yourself for your own purpose, then put the dotted line. If that ray is actually not there, then you can put the dotted line for that. Don't give a continuous line. Okay, and don't forget to put the arrow mark also. So here, The ray which appeared to come from the principal focus, after reflection, it will go parallel to the principal axis. That is second rule. The ray which is incident, appeared to incident through the principal focus, after reflection, it will go parallel to the principal axis. Okay, that is second rule. Next, third one. Principal focus, this is P and this is F and this is C. Okay, the ray which appeared to come through the principal, the center of curvature. See, if I am getting a draw like, if it has appeared to come from the principal axis, center of curvature. Okay, so if I am extending that line, it will be falling through the center of curvature. So if the ray is appeared to come from the center of, through the center of curvature, after reflection, it will retrace its path. Okay, so understood this one? So, and then next, the fourth one is, if the ray is incidenting obliquely, what will happen? After reflection, it will diverge from that point. Okay, it will be diverging and going. This is P, this is F, and the same distance C over here also. Okay, clear? So this is the, this is what, this, these are the rules for the image formation in a convex mirror. Okay, so first one is parallel to the principal axis, appear to diverge from the principal focus. So the second one is the ray which appeared to pass through the principal focus, after reflection it will be passing parallel to the principal axis. Third one, if the ray is appearing to incident through the center of curvature, after reflection it will retrace its path. Okay, then the fourth one is angle of incidence. If it is, if the ray is incidenting obliquely, then it will be, our angle of incidence will be equal to angle of reflection. Obeying the laws of reflection, it will be reflecting. Okay, so now we are going to draw the ray diagrams for this convex mirror at different positions. See, what we did for our concave mirror, same way we will do, but that many this number of ray diagrams won't be there, only two diagrams are there, at infinity and between infinity and pole, like that we will explain now. Okay, so next we are going to study about the image formation by a convex mirror using ray diagram. Okay, so this is, first one is infinity, if the object is at infinity. Okay, if the object is at infinity, the ray which is incidenting on the mirror will be, yes, parallel rays. Don't forget that if the object is at infinity, the ray which is coming to the mirror will be, mirror or lens, anything will be, we will consider it as parallel, incident rays will be parallel rays. So here first we are going to draw one convex mirror. Then principal axis, this is pole and this is F and this is C. Okay, then the ray which is passing parallel to the principal axis, what will happen? It will reflect and go, isn't it? It will be, it will appear to reflect through, from the, diverge from the principal focus. So here, the ray which is passing parallel, it will appear to diverge from the principal focus. Okay, so it is not the, what we told in the case of concave mirror, where the reflected ray is meeting, at that point we will get an image, isn't it? But here if we are observing this, we are not, we can't see any ray which is meeting over there. It is, everything is diverging and going. So what we will do, we will extend those rays and we'll try to find out whether any meeting point is there. So we can see it is meeting at the principal focus. So where will be the position of image? Position of image will be at principal focus. Image will be at, so how the image size will be, size of the image will be highly diminished. Isn't it? It's a point sized object. It will be a highly diminished object, highly diminished image. And what will be the nature? Nature, once I told you about the nature, if it is actually meeting, we will get a yes, real inverted image. So here it is actually not meeting anywhere, isn't it? We are making it to meet at one point, isn't it? So that is called as virtual and erect. So the image will be virtual and erect. Okay, clear now how we will be finding out the image, if the position of image, if the object is at infinity. Clear? So next one is, we are going to find out the position of image if the object is between infinity and P, because it is not actually meeting anywhere, isn't it? We are trying to make it meet at some point. Okay, so here we are going to find out where will be the position of, see, this is P, this is F and C. Why we are not considering between P and F or between F and C, all those things, why we are not considering? If an object is there in this side, whether any reflection will happen? No, because light ray will incident here, but no reflection, because it is a non-reflecting side, isn't it? So at this side angle, we don't have any name for that one, isn't it? From infinity to P, no name at all. But here, all the F, C, everything is on the non-reflecting side of the mirror. That is why we can't, no need. If I am keeping one P and F, between P and F, if I am keeping an object, what will do? Yes, nothing will happen, because no image will be forming. Why? Because it is a non-reflecting side. Okay, the image should be there in front of a reflecting side. Then only we will get an image, isn't it? So now we are going to keep an object at any one point, from infinity to P, any one point I can keep. So here we can use any two rules. Okay, the ray which is passing parallel to the principal axis, what will happen? It will go from the principal focus. Yes, it will appear to diverge from the principal focus. Next is the ray which is appear to come from the principal focus. So what will happen? After reflection, it will go parallel. Okay, so don't think the reflected rays are not meeting. What we will do? So we can extend. So we can see at one point those rays are meeting, isn't it? So now, understood, right? So if you want, you can use the other one. See, which is one? If the ray is passing through the center of curvature, like that you can take. Okay, like this also you can take, that is your wish, any one point you can consider. Okay, so it is meeting at one point. So what is the position of the image? Image will be at between P and F. The position of image will be between P and F. What is the size of the image? It is a diminished image, isn't it? Object is of this size and image is of this size. So it will be a diminished image. And what is the nature? It's actually meeting? No. So what will be the nature of the image? Yes, very good. It will be virtual and erect. Virtual image. Virtual and erect. If it is virtual, erect also. Erect means straight, it is. It's not inverted, it's straight, isn't it? So it is virtual and erect. So clear now how we are finding out the image by using a convex mirror. Okay, clear now? So next we are going to find out the uses of convex and concave mirrors. Okay, first one is convex mirror. So convex mirror, tell me, did you see this convex mirrors using somewhere as any useful purpose? Yes, It is used as a rear view mirror, isn't it? Rear view mirror. It is used as a rear view mirror. Why we are using it as a rear view mirror? Why? Because see, a wide area we can see, isn't it? If we are seeing through the rear view mirrors in the vehicle, in vehicle we are using this convex mirror as a our rear view mirrors. It will be giving a wide area. Okay, wide area we can see, and the object will be seeing closer than the actual. Closer than the actual distance. If it is some 500 meters away, we will feel it is some like 300 meters or 200. It's just near to us. Like that, we will see, isn't it? Closer than the actual value, actual distance. Okay, that is another actually good. If it is very closer, so we will be careful. Okay, so that is another thing. So it will be viewing the wide area. So image will be short. Image will be short. If image is short, then we will be getting a, so the convex mirror just now we learned, isn't it? The images will be shorter. But we will be getting a clear image for that one. Clear image it will be, but shorter. Okay, so this is the important. So in parking space also, see in big malls and all, while we are going, while taking the turn, or in apartment also, apartment while we are turning, while we are taking a turn, so usually big convex mirrors will be kept over there at the parking area, isn't it? Because we can see whether that side or this side any vehicles are there or not, or entrance of that big malls and all, we can see the convex mirrors. So in parking space also we will be using this convex mirror. Actually it is using as a rear view mirror. Okay, clear? Now what is the use of this concave mirrors? Okay, in concave mirrors we will be using in torch, headlights, searchlight, everything we will be using the concave mirror. See, at the position of the principal focus, the bulb will be there and it will be, the light will be like a concave mirror in shape. So what will be doing? So the rays which are coming from the principal focus, what will happen after reflection? It will go parallelly. So we will get it's a long distance view. We will be parallel rays. It will be falling parallel to the rays. So it will be going long distance. For that reason only we will be using the headlights and torch and all, we will be using the concave mirror. So why we are using that also you should remember. So if the, it will be giving the, after reflection these rays will be giving a parallel beam of lines, or parallel beam of ray we will be getting. That is why we are using concave mirrors in torch and headlights. Okay, second one, it is using as a shaving mirror. So why it is using as a shaving mirror? Why? Because it is giving a enlarged image. It will be giving the enlarged image of the object. Okay, we will be getting a, actually what is the size of the image object, bigger than that we will be getting the image. So it will be used as a shaving mirror. And then third one, dentist will be using this mirror to see the object size, enlarged image. The reason is same thing only, enlarged image we will be getting. That is why the dentist will be using this mirror. Okay, and one more thing, it is nowadays used in solar furnace also. Solar furnace, what is the use of concave mirror in solar furnace? Yes, it will be able to concentrate all, so the light ray will be coming from the sun. So it will be like a parallel ray. So if we are keeping a concave mirror and the food we want to prepare, the food we are keeping at the position of principal focus, what will happen? All the parallel rays will be concentrating towards the principal focus. So it will be getting cooked off. Okay, cooked. So that is why we are using the concave mirror in solar furnace. Solar furnace means sunlight will be falling on it and the cooking process will happen. So how it is happening, if what is the use of concave mirror in that solar furnace? So the light ray which is coming from infinity will be a parallel ray. So those parallel rays will incident on the concave mirror and will be forming an image, or all the rays will be concentrating at the converging to principal focus. So if we are keeping our food at the principal focus, it will be cooked very fast. Okay, so understood what are the uses of concave mirror. It will be used in torch, headlights, etc. And it will, why it is using so? Because it will be giving an output of parallel beam of rays. Okay, then shaving mirror, and it is used as a dentist will be using those mirrors because it is giving an enlarged view of the object. Okay, then the fourth one is, it is used in solar furnace. Okay, clear? So whatever we learned today, I hope all of you understood. If you like my channel, please don't forget to subscribe the channel and share with your friends also. Thank you for watching. Bye.